This piece of land, which is 1.9 acres along Ginger Road in Kampala, has been housing the country's Electoral Commission offices for the past 27 years. However, a few years back, the Uganda National Roads Authority compensated the commission with 23 billion shillings for them to shift and pave way for the ongoing development of the Kampala flyover construction and road upgrading project. The Electoral Commission chairperson, Justice Simon Byabakama, has confirmed that the relocation exercise, which started late last year, has been completed. And that's the reason they have officially decided to hand over these offices to UNRA to go ahead with the road construction works.
The commission has been able to conduct 5 general elections in this place: 2001, 2006, 2011, 2016, and 2021. Now, we have shifted at an appropriate time. We are going to invite the esteemed members of the press to come and see our new home and tour it and inform the people of Uganda and see the difference between where we were and where we are now in the new home.
From this location, the Electoral Commission's new temporary office premises are now located on plot 1, 2, 3 and 5 on 7th Street Industrial Area, which was formerly the headquarters of the National Housing and Construction Company.
In the new place where we are supposed to be there on a temporary basis. The final journey is to our state-of-the-art home, which is supposed to be constructed in Rubowa. And that process is also ongoing. We hope to be attained or accomplished in the not too distant future. So the current premises, therefore, is merely a stopover process.
Among the items that Justice Simon Byabakama has handed over to UNRA are the files containing particulars of the land. These have been received by Engineer Lawrence Barrio, the contract manager of the Kampala flyover project, who also doubles as the head of structure and bridges at UNRA.
We are receiving these premises to commence construction of lot 2. Under lot 1, we have 1 flyover, 1 underpass, 3 pedestrian bridges, and also we have constructed box culverts to improve drainage. Why are we doing this? For 3 reasons. 1, to mitigate traffic congestion in the city.
According to Engineer Pario, the construction of the Kampala flyover will completely change the flow of traffic in the city. For example, the traffic from Chibuli to the city center will use the new Chibuli Junction towards Nsambia Junction and Clock Tower, while traffic from Chibuli to Mukwano Road will make a right turn at the new section of Mukwano Road. This is going to be phase 2 of the construction of the Kampala flyover project. The first phase is to be fully completed by the end of May this year.
On the lot 2, we could not start construction on lot 2 because we had challenges of land. The lot 2 is going to span over this area. Because we didn't have access to land, we could not be able to commence the works. But in brief, what is entailed in lot 2? Under lot 2, we are going to widen roads here along this corridor. We are even going to construct bus rapid transit routes.
This project, which stretches from the Clock Tower through Nsambia Junction to Mukwano Road, is financed through the Japan International Cooperation Agency at 224 billion shillings for the first phase. The second phase is expected to cost 659 billion shillings. Report compiled by Jaliat Namawaya for the news.